All right, everybody, this is Born Again, and we're gonna bring y'all a video, another video. Me and Kylie got some new things that we want to discuss. The Blackberry Pearl was just released, so a lot of interesting things and things about the Pearl we're gonna discuss. And Kylie had wound up getting the Pearl, and surprisingly, she had gotten it when I thought she was gonna stick with BPN. But hey, it's good, we gotta test it out and see how it goes. So hey, Colin, how you doing?
I'm doing fabulous. How are you doing?
I'm doing great, great. It's amazing that the priv is actually finally here.
Yeah, it's here, guys. So yesterday was the big day on AT&T. I know a lot of people had pre-ordered prior to November 6th, but yesterday was AT&T's release of the Priv, both online and in the store. And I was fortunate enough to be able to go into the store and grab one of these right here. So here's the monstrous sized box that it comes in. So I'll just compare this to a passport so you can see how much box you get there. But yeah, so here's the Priv box. And in that comes, let me get this thing fired up here, guys. That's what I used to have, the AT&T one.
Yeah, here's my passport, which I love. BB10, can't ask for better. Maybe eventually I'll get the Priv, but as of right now, I'm sticking with BB10. So hopefully the updates that's coming out in a couple of months is gonna be okay. We'll see what happens. Whoa, look at that thing! Nice
Here's
big
the
screen and
I got a nice fall background on this one. I decided to upgrade from the standard background that they put on here. And you might see some notifications coming up. I just have everything still turned on. But the screen is beautiful. But I know you guys are all just dying to see it. Here it goes. There it goes right there. And there's that keyboard that we all love so much. I'm aching this back to like a torch type keyboard. There's just a little bit more space up here. Like on the torch, it was really, really hard to type because the bottom bezel part of the slider portion was really close to the keyboard. Where here on the Priv, they've actually given you a little bit more space, and the keyboard's kind of soft type. It's not as clicky as, say, here on your passport. This is really clicky. This is not really so much clicky. But again, I don't know if you guys can hear that or not. But it's a really nice device. It's really light compared to the passport. So if you're weighing it, this guy definitely has some heft to it, whereas this guy's a lot
definitely
lighter.
heavy a phone.
Huh?
It's definitely got a lot of meat to this phone and the passport.
Yeah. A lot of heft. If you throw this at someone, it's gonna really knock them out. If you throw this one at someone, which I wouldn't hope you would do that, it may just kind of irk them or just kind of piss them off. But this one, I think, would just actually knock someone out. I mean, it's pretty hefty. But yeah, so they had a nice display in AT&T. I'll give it to AT&T yesterday. They didn't have the Priv shoved in a back far corner. They had it right next to the desk. They had a big billboard up showing the Priv. And it was really nice. They only had one display model and two units in stock to be sold, which is one more unit more than what they had for the passport from the AT&T stores down here where I live. And I was the first person to come in and purchase a Priv from that store. I was there at 9 in the morning when they opened. But all in all, my experience with AT&T was great. It was easy to walk in, get the device, and get out. And the device is actually very nice. I think anybody that gets a Priv is really going to enjoy it. I'm not going to go into specs on the device. Bart, you and I have already discussed this. There's enough videos out there. If you want to know specs on the device, there's probably about 100 videos out there that'll
Exactly.
explain the
The
specs.
specs wise, I mean, it's very, we know the specs wise, it's got slightly better graphics than the passport and stuff. So I mean, we pretty much know what the specs and all is on here. But the question that remains, you just got this device yesterday or day before yesterday, and how do you like the BlackBerry-ish Android ecosystem that's going on with the Priv?
I'm a real BB10 lover. It's all gesture-based swipes. I love this. This is great. I mean, this is just, to me, it's perfect. And then you got this, which to me is awesome. And I love it. And this is from someone that left Android to come back to BlackBerry, you know.
Androids came a long way because, I mean, I've never really used Android too much. But on my particular tablet, it came with 4.4 KitKat. And when I got the update to the 5.0, there was some differences from the 4.4 KitKat. It was better, but the only time will tell. I mean, at least now you can still get, at least now you can have a fully functional Facebook app, you know. And,
true.
And, I mean, that's the downside of the BB10 is that the actual Facebook app is just horrible. And I actually have a version of the Android on my passport that I use to get all the extra goodies from Facebook. But it definitely needs improvement. So, but hopefully BB10 sticks around.
Hopefully so. Hopefully. I enjoy the hub, so you can just press there, come up here. And then here's your hub, so you guys kind of get to see everything in my hub tonight. But there's the hub right there in all its glory, and you can scroll up and down. And of course, there's your calendar events. But I like the hub. I think it looks really nice. I'm going to echo what a lot of people have already said, especially some people in our group, like Romeo. Dark themes would be great for the hub. Hub, calendar. Things like that, it would be nice, even contacts, it'd be nice to see some dark themes implemented at some point. Maybe that'll come in a software update. I don't know.
Well, at some point, Marshmallow is going to come out. It's going to probably eventually be released for the passport. So I don't know the differences between Marshmallow and the 5.1.2. What's the major differences in it? You know, time will tell. But for as BlackBerry promising that they're going to actually update this monthly. So my case in point is that what's going to happen is that they're going to, just like when BB10 10.1 had originally was released, it was good, but it wasn't great. So as BB10 evolved,
my roommate came home.
Okay. That's fine. That's fine.
And, my dog's going to be barking for about 10 minutes, probably.
Well, that's fine. But, just like with the Priv, these apps that's part of the Priv can be updated. Actually, can be updated pretty quickly. Monthly, weekly, whatever BlackBerry wants to do. And, it wouldn't take them long to actually get the Android version really good. Probably maybe even better than BB10 at some point. Only time will tell as the system evolves. You know? What you think about that?
I think, you know, as the device matures, you know, it's just now hitting the market right now. Everybody's just getting it to their hands.
Exactly.
You know, so over the coming, you know, November, December timeframe, as the holidays start to roll around and people are out shopping for new devices or getting devices as gifts for people, I'm really hoping that people can notice the BlackBerry, that when they walk into AT&T or hopefully soon Verizon and the other carriers. I don't know when it's supposed to hit those other carriers, but hopefully soon.
It makes it for the holidays and then not next year or something, the beginning of the year.
Yeah, I don't want to see our brothers and sisters on the other carriers left out, you know? I mean, I don't want to see them.
Verizon, we know some people that actually have still got Z10s on Verizon and they don't have a passport. They don't have leaps. They don't have the things that we have. We're fortunate that we on a GSN network that all the BlackBerry phones can work on these networks and not CDM. And it definitely an advantage. So hopefully BlackBerry can bring a few devices to them as well in the future.
Yeah. You know, but as those devices start coming online, you know, hopefully BlackBerry will start pushing out, you know, quicker updates and stuff like that to some of these apps. One thing I would like to point out to any owners of Pribs or anybody that gets a Prib is as soon as you get the device, go into the Google Play Store and just search for BlackBerry. Okay, when I first got my Prib, when I went to update all my apps, the BlackBerry apps did not show up in there. So what you'll need to do is actually type in BlackBerry and then find all the BlackBerry apps and then do an update of those. I think there's like 7 or 8 different apps, but you'll need to update those and then go ahead and install any other apps you want. But I would make sure to do that first.
Yeah, definitely. It's always good to update your apps because the original apps that come with the passport or with the Prib might be slightly buggy. And if you don't know to update them, you're missing out on a couple of features and benefits of having the actual updated app. So it's a really good point, Collie. Anything else with the Prib that you like to speak about with the actual how the phone functions and stuff? Is it's pretty quick overall? I mean,
it's running
Android is, or is it really like DB10?
It's running Android 5.1.1 straight out of the box. It's pretty quick. Now, you'll read things in forums and you'll hear people tweet and post that the device gets really warm, especially right back here. It gets really warm. Now, the first day I had the device, I had it plugged into the wall, and I was downloading about 20 apps and updating other apps at the same time. And I was texting a couple of people, too. I was really excited to have the device. Couldn't wait to get it and just break this thing in. Well, it got so hot back here, literally, I almost could not touch it. It was so unbearably hot, or I should say warm. I don't want to say blazing hot or nothing, but it got pretty uncomfortable. So I had to set it down for a while, let it do everything it was doing. And then once it calmed down, the device has been pretty good. It's really cool back here. I haven't really had any other issues with it heating up.
Well, it's just similar to as the passport. When you have any updates that you install, your phone's going to run slower because you're updating these apps, and it runs a little hotter. Just like with the passport right here, on this side of the screen, when you charge it, it doesn't do it on the bottom where the charging port's at, but only does it on the top. Right here in the corner, it gets hot, warm to touch. And I don't, that's where the actual charging mechanism is at for the computer with the sensor. But the passport kind of does the same thing, because the way the computer is actually at on the passport, it's like this, the computer. For the passport, and the battery is on this side of it. So it could be very well that might be where the actual sensor is at, for where the battery connects to, from the battery to the actual motherboard. And it was getting hot because you was using it and so forth to download the apps, actual apps. So how many apps do we have on there that you actually had fun downloading?
I'll show you what my app tray looks like. Hold on. Oh, cool. I got quite a lot. So, I mean, I'll probably get more here soon, but I mean, I've got all of these. I'm sure there's people out there that are like, well, this is nothing. I've got 10 times more of that. But for me, that's a lot of apps right there. But I'll have more apps here pretty soon too. I've only downloaded really what I use constantly all the time.
Close to almost 200 apps.
Yeah.
And majority of them I use and some I don't. I recently did a video how to delete apps that shows you how to remove the apps and stuff. So Definitely interesting. When you get tons of apps, you just sometimes you got to clean house, and sometimes you need the apps. You always go back and forth. But it's good to have a community.
Yeah. And I've got a nice little screen recorder app over here on my phone. It's the AZ Screen Recorder. You can get it from the Google Play Store. And I'm going to be using that app here pretty soon to start doing how-to videos on the Android operating system, on the BlackBerry crib, navigating through some of the different apps, and I'll be doing some app reviews off of this device. So stay tuned for that as well. Bart and I we're getting a lot more active in this than what we've been, especially now that Bart's got his new webcam. So,
and I have a review video on it, that will be uploaded in a few days.
Now, you know, something, you know, I know you guys noticed that, you know, there's a lot of blurbs and things going on in our videos, and you can hear the dogs barking a minute ago. It's because Bart and I are just fans that love to do these kind of videos for the fans. And we don't really edit our videos. We just shoot them in the raw, and then we just put them up. You know, because we love doing this. We love these devices. We love the community of BlackBerry. We like what it stands for. We just have a great time with this. And we just like sharing with y'all our experiences as just everyday users. I mean, yeah, we're on the techie side as well, but we're also just everyday users of these devices. And we just like sharing our experiences with y'all.
We're showing our BlackBerry love for y'all by actually doing, by just getting together and doing it. So it's kind of, I guess, of a strange blessing how we had met and came about to start doing this. We are 6 months later, and I got right at 20 videos on my YouTube channel, and I know it will continue to grow, because as we continue to do more like this, and we just want y'all to know that we enjoy it, and that we hope y'all enjoy our videos as well. So let us know what y'all think. Post comments in the description of the video. If you know us on Twitter, leave us a tweet, and we'll see what, if you got something you want to discuss, tweet me or Kali. Let us know. There's something you like to see or you want to ask, you know, because, I don't brag about it, but there's a lot of things I know about BB10. I don't know everything, but if I don't know it, I'll find out. There's always ways of finding out things about it. So just post your questions if you have any, and let me and Kylie know, and we'll do our best to answer it for y'all. Because like we say, we both love BlackBerry, and we're big fans. You know, we're not corporate sponsors. We're not, you know, elites. I wish we had that, the right to be elites. I don't know what's the requirement to be an elite, but we are elites in our own right mind, because the love that we have for BlackBerry. And your colleague can tell you the exact same thing. So we want to thank y'all for our followers and subscribers that, you know, we hope to continue to grow.
And one thing about the Priv too is it came with some really neat little earbuds. I just want to throw these out, because usually the earbuds just don't get enough attention. But these are different than what the Passport chip was. So these actually have, I don't know if you guys can see it, the little BlackBerry logo on them. I think Bart's trying to fish his out.
I got him.
Yeah, you can see the BlackBerry logo. So these are actually pretty nice. And the little plastic part actually fits really nice in the ear too.
See the Passport ones, those that has the Passport, it has the anti-tangle cord, and it's got these little bitty pieces that you take off and fits in your ear, and you got to fit them a certain way in your ear for them to not come out. But I checked online for the ones Kylie's got. They're not available yet, but at shop.blackberry.com they sell for $29 at shop.blackberry.com. They're not available, they're out of stock, they're not even selling them yet, but they do have a price on them. And I bought these. This is my second set. I had to replace mine already for my passport because my little feline, I got her on there, like to devour my clothes. So, but I paid $11 for these on Amazon, the original passport headphones. So they work really well. So I like the one Carly's got because it actually got the BlackBerry logo on them. Definitely going to pick me up a pair.
So one thing I noticed about the keyboard on the Priv, and I'll just throw this out here. I don't know if it's just my particular device or if it's on other Privs. And it very well may be designed to do this. I don't know yet. So if anybody out there knows, hit us up in the comments and leave us some feedback on this. But I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see this or not when I do this. But when you press down on the keyboard on the Priv, it's very spongy. Like you can actually see the keyboard go down, the whole thing, even these little plastic lines in between the keys, you can see the whole thing just kind of go down. And it's more so here in the center section of the keyboard. So if any other Priv users have noticed that, or if anybody knows, anybody from BlackBerry or anything, if that's a design aspect of the phone, hit us back and let us know. It's just something I'm curious about, something I noticed. Is it a detractor for me for the device? Not at all. Just something I happen to notice, and I'm the inquisitive type. So other than that, I mean, the phone's pretty solid construction. I mean, it's got a really great grippy feel on the back. When I passed it around at dinner tonight to some friends, all Apple users, the first thing they said was, wow, this phone is really grippy. I mean, they just loved how it felt in the hand. The screen's amazing. Can't beat that slide-out keyboard, you know. But yeah, people were pretty shocked that it said BlackBerry up here at the top. I think they were waiting for it to say Samsung.
You had a picture in the group where it actually shows the charging. When you charge your phone, the charging indicator is on the curve of the display.
I actually took that here with the passport, and I can share that with you guys too. Hold on for just a second. I'll pull that picture up. That's a good point, Bart.
And it's actually out the way. That's on the side of the screen.
So right there on the side of the screen is a charging indicator. So that's kind of cool.
Yeah, definitely very cool. It's actually on the side. If you're away from your phone and you want to see if it's charged, you're laying in the bed, you actually can see what percentage it's at. It's not like the actual passport where you've got to swipe it and swipe up to actually get the percentage. You got a new that peak gesture.
Yep. And folks, I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see this or not. I'm, you know, Bart and I, you know, we're not video, you know, masters or anything like this, but I'm going to hope that you guys can see this. But that's the display that they had up at AT&T. So you can see a clear big billboard of the Priv with people using it. And then down below, they have one model of the Priv, one of the classic, but no passports available. So that's what AT&T had up when I went in there. So, I mean, kudos to them. At least they had that much going. At least they had a working demo of the Priv, fully functional, powered on, working. Same thing in the classic. So kudos to AT&T also for not stuffing it way back in the back corner where nobody ever looks by the budget phones.
I didn't get to go to the local AT&T and see how theirs is set up. But being that you're in a big city over there, you probably got the same kind of demo set up for all the AT&T stores.
Yeah, I've seen somebody else post a similar picture too on Friday.
Definitely good if they can have something when somebody goes into the store, you know, big demo, you know, come see me, you know, this is brand new, which is actually pretty good. I still wish that BlackBerry would have attempted to try to do a little bit of advertising on TV. You know, get with AT&T, see if AT&T could have took their ad, their commercial that created. That nice Priv commercial AT did. That's like a 40-second commercial. Just put it on TV for a couple of times, three times a week or something, until Christmas. Let people see the device and, you know, like, oh, you know, wow, look at this. I mean, show the device sliding up and everything like that. And you know, let people see it before the Christmas holidays comes out, the way, you know, it would help with the sales. And not just online advertising. Online advertising is great, but they need to broaden the horizon a little bit. Because some people don't actually go through the online system to even see the phones. And that's the downside, is that most people, they just go straight up on Facebook and stuff. Unless I have, let's say I got about 400 contacts, and I'm the only one, there's actually two people in my, or three, counting Kylie, there's actually one other person in my contacts that actually likes and shares my BlackBerry post that I share. Because I'm thinking she has one too. But the thing is that if you got contacts that don't have a BlackBerry, you don't see the advertisement because it's not being shared. Most people don't see this. Mostly things people see is other devices. So, but we're not going to get too much into detail with the advertisement. But, you know, I think they could have did something a little better with the advertising. But I'm glad to see that AT&T took an initiative and changed their display and make it stand out, you know. That we to grab people, you know, when they walk into the store, here I am, the brand new Priv. You know, definitely something good for them. So I wonder why they only had a limited stock. You had been in there, and how many did they actually had in stock?
They had two. Now with the passport, at least here in Houston, from what I've noticed, most of the stores I went to, when the passport was out, they only carried one. What the AT&T would do is they would have one in stock, they would sell it, and then once they sold that one, they would order one and get one back in stock. Now what they're doing, at least down here in my neck of the woods, southwest side of Houston, is they're carrying two in stock, and then as they sell those two, they'll order two new ones. Now I've heard stories of some AT&T stores having five, maybe a few more. It might be also based in geographic regions, you know, so one region may sell a lot more of a particular device than another, so of course they'll carry more devices in another area.
I actually checked my store on the online and see if they had it in stock, and it actually they didn't show on stock. And you could go in to pick it up at the store if it was shipped to the store, but they didn't have it actually in stock.
Every store in a 25-mile radius around me had them in stock here in Houston. I was really surprised.
Need a big demand if they needed to, if they had two or five or whatever, they could have went to one store and try to get it at another store. At least they had them in the store, and yep. You can see the demand. Well, they sold the two. We need to get two more overnight, you know, or maybe they'll get five next go around and see. But you figure if they got, I don't know how many AT&T stores they have in the United States, but if each store had two Privs, you know, that's quite a bit of supply.
I know here in Houston there seems to be an AT&T store on darn near every corner, it seems like. It's like everywhere you drive there's an AT&T store. I'm not talking about the authorized retailers either. I'm talking about the actual company stores. There's a ton of them here in Houston. So your chances of getting a device here in Houston are pretty good. So if there's anybody here in Houston, any Houstonians, or even Texas in general, I know we have guys in San Antonio and Austin that do these videos and stuff too. Hey, your local stores have these. Go grab one, check it out. I'm not a huge major advocate of Android, as most people would know. I came from Android, I left Android, and came back to BlackBerry because I really miss the experience. However, as a BlackBerry lover, and as a BlackBerry fan, I wanted to try this out. All right, so I know there was a lot of people shocked that I ended up actually getting the device after I've been saying, no, I'm not going to get the device. But I needed, just for myself, to try this thing out. I needed to see what they've done, how far Android's come since at least I last used it. Because when I last used it was kind of a crummy experience for me. Now, that's not to say it's crummy for everybody. So I wanted to give this a shot and check it out. Then I can share my experience with people in my BBM groups and stuff like that, learn some new things, and you know, I guess teach people about some things that I find out too through some of my experiences.
Everything's a learning experience. I mean, it's like me. I mean, I got to learn to be optimistic about it. You know, I mean, I love BB10. You know, it's a wonderful system. But, you know, I have to give the Priv that, you know, that marginal room a chance, you know, to say, you know, I want, bottom line is, I'm going to support the device regardless if whether it's Android or not, because the thing is that, you know, if you're going to support BlackBerry, you're going to support them regardless what system, ecosystem they're using. Because, I mean, they have BB7. Then they had, now they got OS 10, and now they're running Android. I mean, things evolve, things change, you know. I mean, if we're going to be true diehard BlackBerry fans, you know, we're going to move along as the ecosystem moves along. You know, and I think that I came to that realization, you know, when a few weeks ago when I kind of had seen the possibilities of the Priv and stuff. So, definitely something to look forward to.
Well, I mean, I don't know if we as users have to move on with it as it moves on. John Chin, you know, you and I were discussing this earlier when John Chin said they've got other things coming out.
Yeah.
Is there some more BB10 goodness going to come out? Maybe. I mean, who knows? Who really knows? We don't know until they pop the word out.
Three, for sure. And March. But yeah. If there's a possibility 10.4 will come out, or maybe another BB10 device later on or something, or it's in the air, but these things that we're saying, but the possibilities are there. So
But the thing is, we just don't know. We don't know what John Chin meant by that. We don't know if it's software related, if it's hardware related. We just don't know. Wasn't very clear there. I think so. I think they've got some possibly, hopefully, really exciting things coming out for us, hopefully for the consumer market, and not always just based on enterprise. I know that they are an enterprise company at heart. But still, there's a lot of consumers out here that actually love BlackBerry too. So hopefully they'll kind of cater to a little bit of that, as well as the enterprise market too. But I mean, possible exciting times ahead for us. I mean, and BlackBerry as a whole. So we're just really going to have to wait, see what this new year is going to bring, and see what John Chin's going to throw out there for everybody.
I agree. There's a lot of things that's evolving, you know, and just like I watched a video where John Chin had mentioned about connected world, connected everything. You know, and I couldn't understand. He had said enterprise, but I kind of realized something he said. It's enterprise is not just necessarily about business owners. They want to change the outlook of BlackBerry and the way they look at technology. They got connected cars now, where BlackBerry software is in Ford Motor Company. That's one of the biggest companies they got around, and BlackBerry software is in there, is in the actual 2016 trucks and all, and even Porsche and other companies. So he said it's possibility that one day you could be able to sit in your car and turn your washing machine on with BlackBerry software, and you know, from your car, that connectivity. And he wants BlackBerry to be a part of that. So, I mean, there's a more things about BlackBerry that we not fully understanding the direction that BlackBerry has in store for us. And it's kind of funny, I talk with my hands, but it's a habit, as y'all can see. But I'm sorry about that with the hand movement, but it's just a bad habit. But anyway, yeah, they definitely possibly great things to come. So we just gotta, you know, it might be a slow recovery. They are not doing too good, but we just gotta keep having faith in them that they will recover, you know, at some point, and we have to just see where it goes.
Yeah, pretty much.
But definitely, because the BB10 is a great system, you know, no apps and stuff, you know, that ecosystem. We have to see what's going to happen with that, whereas with BB10, Android system with the Priv, new possibilities in the future, definitely something to look forward to. So how you liking that all touch keyboard on there? Wait, that reminds me, oh, I got it right here. Actually, my old trusty Z10 is right here. And the past, that keyboard reminds me identical to the actual keyboard on the fire it up and get it started, and I'll show you
the keyboard's actually really, really nice. I've actually found myself using the on-screen keyboard more than the actual physical keyboard, believe it or not. It's just really, it's really fun to type on that, and you can type really fast.
I liked it, the Z10, because of that. What you think about the swipe gestures, how you can write entire sentences?
Oh, I like that. I like that. As the more you use it,
the actual keys.
Well, the more you use it, the more intuitive it becomes, and it starts learning all this stuff. But when I want the wow effect, I just do that and just pop that up, you know. And it's, and even the physical keyboard. Sorry, I had a brain fart there and forgot what I was going to say. is a joy to use too. So I mean, it's a lot of fun. And I even learned that you can dictate your message to someone tonight too from the physical keyboard by this little, there's a little microphone button down here, and you can press that and actually speak your message in BBM. I didn't know that. So again, I'm finding out new things every single day. But just a solid device in my opinion. I mean, there's a few things here and there. Yeah, the dark themes. One of our members was having some problems with an SD card today. I'm not sure if that issue got resolved. I'm not sure if any other people have been having issues with SD cards. I'd like to hear if people have. But I mean, as more people start getting this in their hand, we're going to hear more things, good things, bad things, indifferent things, whatever. But as you guys start getting the Priv in your hands, we would love to hear your thoughts and hear what you think about the device.
I just looking at that screen from you showing off, and it's like the clarity of it of that screen is just, I mean, it pops out on you, man. That is a really good screen.
It really does.
That HD display is really good.
And that's not even full brightness.
Record, huh?
That's not even full brightness either. I have it down low.
You could even record in 4K with it. So I mean, if you got a 4K television or 4K equipment, you actually can have some seriously nice looking video in 4K. I'm not sure if the actual screen itself is 4K, the playback can render the 4K or not. It probably can, but to really get the full benefit of it, you would need a good 4K screen. And that's amazing that they actually included that in there. And that phone can handle 2 terabytes of screen. I mean, look at the clarity of that dessert. Mmm, it make me hungry.
That's a chocolate lava cake from dinner tonight. Ooh. And then I took a, here, for all you steak aficionados out there, here's some rare steak. So hopefully no one has a heart attack. But these are all low light photos. I took all of these in very low light conditions at the restaurant I ate at. There's the mountain of meat on the plate. So this was all done low light conditions. And the priv handled it perfectly without a doubt. And these are all stock settings. I didn't do any macro settings or change the lighting or nothing like that. Everything's still set to stock. But yeah, it shot great. I'm really happy with the device so far. My nitpicks are the same as most users have been. I just had the one about the keyboard, but again, that's just a personal thing. The dark themes inside contacts, like to see that inside calendar. I'd like to see a dark theme hub if we could, just an idea. That's what I've got so far. Loving the device. And like I said, I'll be doing some how-to videos here within the next few days on some apps and how to navigate through the system. So,
and I will be doing some how-to videos in the coming weeks. Something that's really cool that you actually can do with your passport that only a few people I actually told to, but y'all will be amazed at this one particular app that I'm actually going to review on BB10 and what it actually can do. And I should have downloaded this app 2 years ago, but I downloaded it the other day and I'm just amazed by it. So I'm not going to give it out. So I want to actually do the video and let y'all see it firsthand. So, but now that I got a brand new camera, definitely I can do the video a little bit better, actually demonstrate it, and a lot better like that. So I'll have that done in a few weeks, because I got a bunch of videos that I want to do. So in the next few weeks it will be very interesting, and just like with Kali, we're going to be doing some videos together, so there'll be
on the lookout.
It'll be great. Yeah, so just please just subscribe if you new, never seen our videos, subscribe to my channel and Kali's channel. Definitely worth checking out. So
yeah, feel free to hit us up on Instagram. I'm the cool girl. Cool is K-E-W-L, not C-O-O-L, so the cool girl. And then on Twitter, I am coolgirl05. And on YouTube, I am Kylie Texas Girl.
Yeah, and I'm on my Twitter account is twitter.com/littlebyte76, and my YouTube account is youtube.com/littlebyte76. So those are my two accounts that I have. So feel free to subscribe, and we want to hear what y'all got to say. We're not out to be big fans, the little bit of subscribers we have, we're grateful and thankful for what we have, we're not out to do it for power or to fame. We just want to do it because we like to do it, we enjoy it, it's fun, and we get enjoyment out of y'all knowing that y'all like our videos. And it encourages us to do more videos. So that's what the videos are about. Y'all. And the BlackBerry user that wants to know from other BlackBerry users, me and Kylie and other people in the group, from users, how BlackBerry is and things going on with BlackBerry. What better way to know BlackBerry than from a BlackBerry user? So definitely a lot of good things to come. So anything else you'd like to say or think of,
Kylie? Not really. If you get the priv, feel free, you can message me on Twitter, you can hit me up on Instagram, or we have a comment on the YouTube video. Best way to get a hold of me is via Twitter. And if you have any questions, just ask. I'll tell you exactly at least how I feel or what I think about the issue, or try to help you out with it as best as I can. I'm pretty reachable, so just let me know if there's anything that you guys want to discuss. And Bart and I, down the road, once we get a little bit better at this, because we're still new somewhat, but we'll do a video answering some of y'all's questions or replying to some of y'all's comments too. Just to let you know, we're here for you guys. We're just fans doing this for the fans. That's it. I just enjoy this stuff, as do many of the users that we know. We come in all shapes and forms. We're tech lovers, we're phone users. It doesn't matter what you do out there. Do it, have fun with it. But we just want you guys to know that we're just here, I don't know. I guess I'm kind of rambling. but we're just normal people. We're not like some of these other guys have millions of views on videos and stuff. That's not us. We're just two average people just kicking it back, having a lot of fun with this and enjoying it. You see, this isn't scripted. We're not cutting anything out. So what you see is what you get. We've been doing this for about 46 minutes now. It's a little bit long of a video for us usually, but we get to rambling sometimes, so you don't have to put that in the comments. We're already aware of it.
Definitely. No, we do understand that, some people get bored. The videos is too long. So we definitely understand that. So some of our videos may not be this long. So to try to accommodate that.
We're going to work on that.
So bear with us. As we get better, we may have better and shorter videos. So definitely going to improve on that. So I want to thank y'all for watching, and please remember to like, share, and subscribe, and leave comments and questions and anything that you have. And I'm Bart, and thanks for watching.
Get the priv. You won't be sorry.